Over the years, I found myself in the deserts of Rajasthan, often in love, looking at love stories painted into those crumbling haveli walls with crushed mineral and camel bone. In these surviving 17th century painted buildings, you see winged head cherubs, angels, simurgh mystical birds, cypress trees, lotuses, and Sufi tales of Leela and Majnu, Heer and Ranja, Soni and Mahiwal. All of these stories of love, forbidden and fought for, are hand-painted into stone as a reminder to choose love against all odds. And what is astoundingly beautiful about these images is that they are long, long preservations of someone's imagination and feeling. They remind us that our cityscapes and civilizations don't have to be spaces devoid of emotion, but can be embedded with secrets that live for centuries. As I walk down the winding streets of Shekhavati, looking at painted men fading into dust, I see the spirits of these painters with their paintbrushes and bowls of paints in their hand. I see them smiling to themselves as they paint lovers in amorous embrace, knowing that love always lives. And while monuments of love like the Taj Mahal and garden tombs were erected by king and queens and those with privilege, those of us who only have our dreams meticulously carve our love into the same monumental stone. We write M hearts H, D hearts K. It's no small feat, digging into ancient rock to make impressions of their initials to mark love immortal. What excites me about these people meticulously carving an initial into tree bark or monument is the sincere effort it takes in public space to keep a secret. How many Q, K, P, Fs had hearted each other on the streets, only for each other's knowing and loving? This liminal space between the private and secret and public is what is most exciting to me, because it's where all borders and binaries begin to disappear. That as we immerse a giant idol of God made of mud into the ocean, I also drown with it things that within myself that I want to dissolve. That as we lift up processions to Hussein and his horse Zuljana on our shoulders, we grieve their battles and we mourn our own metaphorical deaths. Growing up in India, there are deep wounds left behind by moments when riots have flooded the streets with rage and violence has existed. And this is precisely why we need more floods of love, of joy, of togetherness that is not bound by national or religious identity, but revels in the simple ecstasy of being human. Our shared realities, interior worlds, glimmer underneath the surface, waiting to be revealed and released. And this is why our public art exists, to record the histories and love stories of everyday and extraordinary people.